Namaskar, why we do, what is the need of this. So today we will be understanding what exactly Ayurveda says or define this Garbha. Okay, so this Garbha means the union of Shukra, Shonit and Atma inside the Kukshi is known as Garbha. Okay, so in English or in modern science we say that zygote or an embryo. Okay, and this embryo grows further and become fetus later. Okay, so one, it is, you know, but this formation happens with the union of three factors here, and this, the last factor, that is soul, which has been very important factor considered by our ancient science, that is Ayurveda. And it is not mentioned in modern science. This is very big difference for, you know, which we see in defining and understanding this whole life. Okay, when the Atma comes or Jiva comes, then only life starts. Just integration of Shukra, or that is sperm and ovum, doesn't create life. Okay, but if you see fertilization definition, you will see in all modern books, it's a union of just sperm and ovum. Okay, now Kukshi means womb of that woman. Okay, Kukshi word is written in the Sanskrit. So the definition what Acharya Charak has mentioned in its Sanhita, that is Shukra Shonita Jiva Sanyuge Tu Khalu Kukshi Gate Garbha Sangya. So this is in Sanskrit language which has been mentioned. So all of you clear with this definition? Yeah. Now moving ahead, what is sanskar means? So sanskar define in the Ayurvedic scripture, that is in Charak Sanhita again, that sanskarohi gunantar adhana means, guna means positive characteristics in you, right? We always understand in general also that this person has a lot of sanskar, good sanskar, right? Or culture, when you behave in a very good manner. So that is what sanskara define in Ayurveda, that when you have been able, the process through which you can add value, virtue or special qualities in that particular life which has been created in the womb. So Garbha means creation of the life in combination of Shukra, Shonit and Jiva, okay, together. But after creation, again, there are opportunity been given to the mother, specifically more responsibility given to the mother, so that she along with her spouse can add more sanskara to them, so that the child which has been created, or the life which has been created, it should not be, you know, it should not be defective, or it should not go just halfway, like in miscarriage or something which happens. Okay, so then the cultivation start. So not only that, that healthiness has been expected here, even special characteristic you can add with special your tools and technique, which we will learn in this particular course. Okay, so this refinement, it means actually refinement in the guna, and also elimination of the toxins or some dosha which has already present in bija, that is sperm and ovum. Because we being the human being, we all have plus and minus point in us, right? Or couple who are there, who are looking for conception, they also have some disorders. And nowadays, our life is so hectic and we are not at all aware about our own health. Although we talk a lot about health, but we are not at all careful towards our health. So in them also, there are a lot of hormonal disorders, there are a lot of lifestyle disorders, genetic disorders, which are already present in male and female body, right? So what sanskara means? Sanskara says that don't only look at when you are pregnant and that time you try to eliminate whatever the factors are there. Sometime women realize when she become pregnant, and that time when she does sonography, she realize that along with baby, she has fibroid in the womb. She has some cyst in the womb. Till that, she is not at all aware about it, because nobody does sonography without any problem, right? When the problem manifests, then only we go for investigation, and then we got to know, oh, this is what we have in our body, right? So this is very important part of sanskara, that is detoxification in that, all that elements which you have. Don't go directly for the conception. Before that, just take conscious action to detoxification in this dosha, and then after you just eliminate those problems, then under the medical guidance, under the yoga consultant guidance, you can start refining the guna. Okay, after what you do refinement means adding some fertilizer. Now here I have shown you one picture, that is what is this mango? What kind of mango would you like to eat?
Alfenzo
mango. Why not simple mango?
The best quality.
Exactly. Even buying, if we go somewhere for shopping, nowadays we are not going out because of lockdown, we are missing that. But even when you go out for shopping, what you see? Best thing, I should get best thing. Right? Even this conscious thought, if couple can create, everybody wants best child. No doubt about it. Okay, that goes default. It is a default understanding that they will have best child, whatever. But then for that best, creating that best, have you done any effort behind it? Conscious effort. Have you gone through such a means kind of, you know, the what we say austerity in yoga, you know, tapa. Tapa, Swadhyaya, Ishwar, Pranidhan, these are the niyama which has been written, right? So this tapa means austerity. Swadhyaya means self-study of self-body and trying to, you know, integrate together and invoking divine power for the same. So tapa, Swadhyaya, Ishwar, Pranidhan, this is Kriya Yoga, which is very easy to do. If you follow regularly in your routine life, it's not the process which will suddenly, you know, it will happen. It need a lot of time to work on self and to become the best version of yourself, so that you can create together best version of your union. Okay. So this is how we can create best that Alfenzo, like Alfenzo mango, you can create best version of your life, future life, right? So this is what about sanskara. So conception is the subtle process and it is a divine process. It carries various impression in which there is always possibility of addition of values, virtue and special qualities. So finally, refinement in guna and detoxification in dosha is the consistent process. Remember this, mark this consistent. नहीं तो क्या होता है, नाउ यू हैव साइंड अप, यू आर इन लर्निंग प्रोसेस, 20 डेज यू विल बी एंथुजियास्टिक ऑफ दिस पर्टिकुलर सब्जेक्ट, वंस यू जस्ट आफ्टर 20 डेज स्टिल दिस इम्प्रेशन और इफेक्ट्स विल लास्ट फॉर सम मोर 20 डेज, लेट अस कंसिडर, आफ्टर दैट 2 months, 3 months, जस्ट गॉन. सो दिस शुड नॉट बी लाइक दिस. ओके, so if you really want to work and become a best teacher and best guide for other, you need to have that consistent effort to learn, upgrade your knowledge, be an observer, be under the guidance of specialist, and then see you will become best. Okay, everybody, this course will also teach you asanas, breathing and concentration practices for general well-being. The concepts are from different disciplines, but I will simplify them and connect for you.